Despite disagreeing with car advice that the outgoing Cherokee was somewhat unattractive, Brian Linder, Jeep Design Studio Chief, admitted the medium SUV was ready for a redesign. There's little doubt the styling of the old model was a love or hate proposition, and with a focus more on premium styling and refinement for the new model, that shark style front end has gone the way of the dodo. I would admit it needed change, Linder told Australian journalists. You kind of have to go back and think about when we did launch the MY14, that segment was pretty much all FWD architecture. The old design justified the upright boxy Jeep styling. Linder went on to reference other, less off-road focused SUVs in this segment moving away from more traditional designs looking to make a style statement. We knew the new platform wouldn't feature a boxy Jeep on top, Linder said. We wanted to leapfrog where everyone was going, sleeker, with a lower front profile, changing the language in that segment. We wanted something that would stand out, and the Cherokee couldn't be a me-too vehicle in that segment. There is an element of difficulty involved. Some brands suffer it more than others, when designers sit down to remake something that is either iconic or beset with expectations from an enthusiast buying public, and Jeep is certainly one of those brands. We would never have done what we did on the 14 Cherokee to the Wrangler, because it has to look like a certain way, Linder says, confirming that very fact. As far as being adventurous on the styling, we think of ourselves as almost curators of the Wrangler. We have to put our own ego aside as designers. We are there to support the heritage of that vehicle. Did the Jeep styling gurus go too far with the outgoing Cherokee, given the way in which the public criticized the styling, and avoided buying what was an otherwise solid, value-packed SUV in the midsize segment? I don't think we went too far, no, Linder said. I think the old Cherokee, Trailhawk, was kick-ass. It looked like a show car on the road. And it was meant to be polarizing. It's the old design adage, that vanilla is boring and to succeed you must offend nearly as many people as you attract. The Cherokee certainly did that. And yet, despite consistently disagreeing with anyone who asked, that controversial front end is gone for the new model.